Now we will see the vibrating or mechanical resonance type frequency meter. It is also called as vibrating reed type frequency meter. So what does it mean by vibrating reed? So reed, it is a component that vibrates, right? It creates the vibration. So depending upon that vibration, we can calculate the frequency. Okay, so what is reed? We will understand what is reed first. So this is the basically reed. Here you can see this is the diagram of reed, and in this diagram, this whatever you are seeing, this, these are the reeds, right? These are the reeds. These reeds are nothing but the thin steel strips. They are placed along row wise, right? They are placed along the row wise. There is one electromagnet. So here you can see this is the coil. So this is our coil. So we all know what is electromagnet. Whenever we wound the coil around the iron or iron piece, then and when we give the supply, what will happen? Electromagnet is formed. That is, magnet is formed, and it is named as electromagnet. So similarly here, in between here, we have placed the electromagnet. The core, whatever the core is there, it is laminated. Why we laminate the core? Because to reduce or to maintain the losses, we do this. We do the lamination. Okay. Now we will see about the reeds. So is it clear? These are our reeds. Here is one electromagnet is placed in between here, and from here we are going to give the supply. Okay. So now we will see, and our core is laminated. Why our core is laminated? To reduce the losses or to maintain the losses. So we will first understand about the reeds. So whatever I am telling you, same you have to write in your paper. So reed. So what is reed? As I told you, reed is basically component that makes the vibrations, right? It produces the vibrations. So this dimensions of this reed is 4 mm, it is 4 mm wide, and 0.5 mm it is thick. Okay. Now this dimensions or this whatever I told you the dimensions, they may get vary, right? They may get differ according to reed to reed. Now here you can see the upper part, right? So this upper part of the reed is always colored or painted white, okay, and it is called as flag. So just remember, this upper part is always painted white and it is called as flag. So the dimensions, whatever I told, the dimensions, they depend upon or they depend upon the weight of this flag, right? So it will differ according to the weight of the flag. So these reeds are arranged in ascending order. That means a small one is first, then big, right? So they are arranged in the ascending orders. The whatever the difference is there between these two reeds is 0.5 hertz. So first, if the value is 48 hertz, then second reed will be 48.5 hertz. Why? Because the difference is 0.5 hertz. So the range of this frequency meter is 47 hertz to 53 hertz. So just remember, this is our range. So now what we understood till here, that our reeds are connected. Here you can see in diagram, these reeds are connected. Electromagnet is placed here in between, right? This is the electromagnet. Here we place the electromagnet, and our core is laminated, right? And we connect whatever we are going to measure frequency, we connect it here in this terminals. So when the frequency meter is connected, so this is our frequency meter, right? So why we use frequency meter? To measure the frequency. So whenever this frequency meter is connected across the supply, whose frequency is to be measured, right? Whose frequency is to be measured? What will happen? From the coil current will flow, right? The current I will flow from this coil. So what will happen whenever the current will flow? It will form a electromagnet, right? Then what will happen? Magnetic field will be created here, and due to that magnetic field, flux will get created, and due to that flux, what will happen? There will be some force exerted, right? This force is proportional to I square. This force is proportional to the square of the current, and therefore this force varies twice the supply frequency. Just remember, this force will vary twice the supply frequency. Okay. So what will happen? this all reeds will have their own natural frequency, right? They all will have their own natural frequency. So what will happen due to that force? All the reeds will get vibrate. All the reeds will produce vibration. So all the reeds will exert the vibration, and reed whose natural frequency, so this will have its own natural frequency, right? So whichever the reed's natural frequency is equal to the twice the supply of the frequency will vibrate the most. So what you have to understand here, whichever the reed, any one of the reed, natural frequency of any one reed, which will be equal to twice the frequency of supply, that reed will vibrate more compared to other reeds. It will vibrate more, right? So how we calculate the frequency? Whatever the most vibrating reed is there, it will display the frequency here. So what is point to remember here? That this will have its own natural frequency, right? So the natural frequency of any of the reed which is equal to the twice the supply of the frequency, it will vibrate more. So this is about the mechanical resonance type frequency meter. It is also called as vibrating reed type. So this is all the theory part written here.